Loud with MNEK on Apple Music Hits.
It's me. We're back. And I have a friend with me. And I mean, I have a visual right now. So I'm seeing, is this Imani?
This is Imani.
Okay. Well, this is Imani, but it's Mabel.
Hi.
As well. With my, her owner.
With my little dog, who is honestly, she just is all about her.
She sets up shop. She says, this is me.
Right.
But baby, how are you?
I'm good, my love. I'm good. You know, the world is a crazy place at the moment, but we move.
This is an exciting time for you, you know? Like, this is now, let them know, new music.
Mm-hmm.
First new music in literally, like...
a year and a half. Yeah.
Yeah. How are you feeling now that it belongs to the world?
I feel great to have music out again. I definitely, like, took my time to, like, think about what story I wanted to tell, how I want to tell it. I always think, like, I'm here to make people feel good about themselves. Like, that's my mission as an artist, and like making the records that we've been working on, you and me as well. Like, I feel like they're all like kind of confidence anthems in a way.
Yeah, yeah.
So I feel good to be back doing that again.
Tell the people the creative process behind Let Them Know and how it came about.
So we were at a writing camp. Me, in between the lockdown, there was a bunch of us, like you, me, Camille, Ray, SG Lewis, Trey John Marie, Jordan Riley, like so many of us. It was just like good vibes.
And good testing, because we were all tested, just so that people know.
Right.
That. We had a great time.
Right.
We were safe.
Exactly.
We were
all tested.
Let them know.
And
we were safe.
we took all the precautions. It was a safe Kiki. You know, going into making music again when you haven't put solo music out in a long time, it's like, so what am I doing now? Like, I don't want to give people another Don't Call Me Up. Do you know what I mean? Like, I love that moment for us, but it's all about, like, something new. And so I feel like, you know, it was a lot of Zoom calls, right, growth. A lot of me sending super random references to you guys. And then, we got a couple songs that sort of sparked. I was like, okay, cool. Like, this feels like a project. It feels like a story. It feels like a vibe. So then we went to do this writing camp, and I'd obviously made like a long list of references and songs that like really like threw it back and was like, what did I love when I was a kid? And like Madonna, Vogue was like one of my favorite songs to like torture my family with, because I would put on these like long performances. I'd put on these long performances where like if anybody talked, I would start the performance again. We just like started a few different vibes, and then yeah, like Ray and SG Lewis started the initial track. And I remember Ray came upstairs. I was upstairs at the writing camp, like just chilling with my dogs. She was like, babe, it's time. She was like, it's here. The song has arrived. It's here. Like, will you accompany me downstairs? And I was like, okay, cool. And then we just like finished all the writing and like got the vocals. And I feel like we was all vibing for that track, like the day that we wrote it.
Because, I mean, we were all there in that camp, and so many songs, you know, that are possibly going to be ending up on this new album, you know, like, it was so exciting to be in that energy, you know what I mean, of us all making songs together. This idea's coming out of this room, this idea's coming out of that room, and, like, Let Them Know was a constant in the camp that everyone was like, this is just so instant.
And it just feels like, it felt like when we were there, it was like, we knew we were making something special, we all knew that, like, something was happening, but it's like, that is the feeling that I live for as a writer. Like, I don't know how you feel, but it's like the reason why I keep going back to write songs is like that adrenaline that you get, like when you don't really know what something is yet, but you feel like it could be something really powerful.
Nails shine like Christmas, heels on 6 inches, waist inch, smoke, laugh it, you can't hand down, cause baby, you're dead.
Shout out to Ray as well, you know, cause this is like, you know, she's such a supernova. Like, she is, you know, writing and producing, and is an incredible vocalist in her own right. And, you know, this is an important record for her.
She had a lot to do. Obviously, SG Lewis produced it, but, you know, she had a lot to do with the production as well, like, in many ways, because I feel like she really understood my vision. Like, she's one of my closest friends, and she's like my sister. And I feel like, you know, the way that you and I have that connection, where it's almost like I don't even need to say things to you sometimes, and you just know. I feel like she really just like took that tiny little seed that I gave her and like really took it to the finish line. She's very prolific.
The making of this project was absolutely like, you know, something I always looked forward to and just always kept me up at night and excited about music, you know what I mean? So, and I'm excited to have that, to share that with you for real. So
I just don't think that the lockdown would have, obviously it's been difficult for everybody, but like, it is crazy as an artist when you're always on the go and then going from like, I literally came off the tour and then a week later we were in lockdown and like I'd done the Brits and we did a tour and like I'd literally gone twice around the globe the year before and then all of a sudden...
It was like up here, like really, really like buzzing.
And I just feel like mentally I was exhausted from all the work I'd been doing, but I also just like, yeah, just sort of being locked inside and sort of the contrast between what I usually do, like everybody, you know, nobody's used to being inside as much as we have been, but I just don't feel like I would have been in a very good place if it hadn't been for the project and like our little family that we've created.
Wait, okay. So obviously, like, I have enjoyed chatting to you, but I must ask, what was your pick for today's show? As far as song.
Okay, so I literally went through like a whole identity crisis in choosing this song because I was like, there's so many like amazing artists that have like inspired me to sing. But again, I was like, let me go all the way back. And I like, some of my first musical memories are probably listening to Whitney Houston records.
Yes, same.
Yeah, like, and just being floored by like not only her technical abilities but like just the realness that she brought to like storytelling. The record that I've listened to the most is probably My Love Is Your Love.
Incredible song.
I mean,
incredible song.
Ridiculous song. So that was my pick for today because we love Whitney. I literally didn't go to school for a week when she passed. Like,
oh my God. I literally ran to my mom's room in the middle of the night and had to just wake her up to tell her that. It was it's so, like, every time I listen to her music now, it's just, like, so sad. What a loss, you know what I mean?
What a loss. And, like, I just think about how much amazing music we have missed out on. And also, you know, being in the public eye, like, you know what it's like. I always have loved her, but, like, understanding that it's not always easy and like on that scale, like what she was going through, it wasn't her fault. Like, I don't know. I just think it's such a tragedy.
My Love Is Your Love is so wholesome and such a perfect like Wyclef Jean on the pen and the beat. I mean, come on, it's just a classic.
Right.
So you chose very, very well with this one. So we're going to be playing My Love Is Your Love by Whitney Houston. Mabel, thank you so, so much. I love you,
thank you
muchly.
Peter. I love you so much. And I love you much, muchly.
Much, much, muchly. And I'm going to see you soon in some place.
I can't wait.
You know
how it goes. I can't wait.
All right. Bye.
Kisses, my love. If tomorrow.